Students, now here we discuss our new chapter in this video in the second year chemistry intermediate public examination syllabus. For example, there are the number of metals are present. So metals means already we have to know first A group metals, second A group metals. First A group metals means they are the alkali metals. What are the alkali metals? Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. Similarly, second A group metals, alkali earth metals. Alkali earth metals means beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium and radium. So these all are the metals. Similarly, we have to know in modern periodic table the D block elements. Already we have to know the D block elements is also called as a metals. Similarly, F block element is also called as a metals. Means S block, D and F block elements will act as a metals. Similarly, in P block also some metals and more number of the non-metals will be present. So now, for example, iron, well known metal is the iron. Similarly, argon. Similarly, calcium. Similarly, magnesium. So these metals is present in modern periodic table as a metal. But in naturally, in earth crust, they do not present in its free state. Okay, students. So iron is naturally, it does not exist as a iron. Similarly, calcium is also does not exist as a calcium. So iron in naturally in earth crust, it will be exist in a combined form. Similarly, calcium also exist in naturally as a combined form. Combined form means, for example, iron is combined with the oxygen. Example, it will be formed the iron oxide. Similarly, calcium is combined with the carbon and oxygen. It is exist as a calcium carbonate, CaCO3. That means all metals does not exist in free state. They are exist in combined state in the earth crust. For example, iron is always exist in iron oxide form. Similarly, calcium is exist, example, calcium carbonate form. Aluminium is exist, example, aluminium oxide form. So all metals is exist in combined form. They does not exist in a free state. So here we are required the separately metal. For example, here we are required the iron. But iron is not present in iron state. It is always combined with the oxygen like a iron oxide. So here we are required the iron. So what will here we do? We can separate the iron from iron oxide. Okay, students. So iron always combined with the oxygen as a iron oxide. But here we do not require the oxygen. Here only we are required the iron metal. So what here we can do? We can separate the iron from iron oxide. How we can separate it? So that is our new chapter. That is the principles of general metallurgy. So our new chapter name is the general principles of metallurgy. Nothing but metallurgy or principles or general principles of metallurgy. What is the meaning of the general principles of metallurgy? Simple meaning, metallurgy. Metallurgy means how we can separate the metal from their combined form. How we can separate the metal from their combined form. So the study of that methods will be called as a metallurgy. Nothing but general principles of metallurgy. So here in this general principles of metallurgy, we have to know the some new words, some new terminology. Before that, we have to know the meaning of the mineral. So here the meaning of the mineral. Simple. Mineral means here all metals are in earth crust. They are combined with the any other elements. Simply that is called as a mineral. Means the combined form. Mineral means nothing but the combined form. The combined form will be called as a mineral. For example, dolomite, example calcium carbonate. It is the mineral of the calcium because calcium is not present in free state. What is that? It is combined with carbon and oxygen. So that is called as a minerals. Okay, students, minerals means nothing but it is the combined form of a metals. That will be called as a minerals. So here we have to know the another word, that is the ore. So what is the meaning of the ore? Ore means nothing but it is a one form of the mineral, but it can be defined separately. For example, if the metal can be separated, nothing but extracted. Okay, student, here separated terminology we are using as a extracted. Extracted means nothing but what is that? Separated. So for example, metal can be separated from their mineral. That type of mineral is called as a ore. For example, iron. For example, iron. So for iron, there are the number of minerals will be present. Okay, students, for iron there are the number of minerals will be present. For example, hematite, magnetite, these are the examples for the minerals of the iron. What is that? Minerals of the iron. Simple example, here we write the two types of the minerals, and that one is the hematite, another one is the magnetite. These two are the iron minerals. Here, iron can be separated from their mineral in easiest process, or economically it is the easy process. So that type of mineral will be called as a ore. Okay, student, what is the meaning of ore? Simple meaning, ore means nothing but it is a one form of the mineral. How it can be defined? If the metal can be separated, metal can be separated from their mineral in easiest way. In easiest way, when we compare the economically or in normal methods. So that type of mineral here act as a ore. For example, iron. There are the two type of the minerals will be present. One is the magnetite, another one is the hematite. Okay, student, one is the magnetite and another one is the hematite. So magnetite and hematite, when we compare the these two minerals, iron is easiest. That means iron is easily separated from the hematite. So hematite is called as a ore of the iron. Okay, student, clear? This is the meaning of the ore, and this is the difference between the ore and mineral. Okay, na? So this is the meaning of the mineral and ore. And there are the different types of the ores will be present. Different types of the ores will be present. So one will be native ores. One type of ore is the, what is the? Native ores. Example for that native ores is the silver, iron, mercury, lead and platinum. These will be called as a native ores, means they are exist as a separately metals. They do not combined with any other elements. So that type of ores is called as a native ores. So what are the example for native ores? Silver, iron, mercury, lead and platinum. In this native ore, silver, iron and palladium, these two will be called as a noble metals. Okay student, that will be called as a noble metals. Noble metals, silver, iron, palladium will act as a noble metals. So this is the one type of the ore, that is the native ore. Another type of the ore, that is the simple combined ore. That means ore always combined with the any other elements. So that will be called as a combined ores. So these are the mainly two types of the ores. So this is the meaning about the mineral and ores and combined ores and native ores. Let us observe the some type of the minerals. For example, oxide minerals. Example for that oxide minerals, hematite is example for the oxide mineral. Example, its formula is the Fe2O3. Another one is the magnetite. Its formula is the Fe3O4. Another one is the bauxite. Its formula is Al2O3 2H2O. These are the examples for oxide minerals. Then carbonate minerals. Example, calamine. Get it? CO3 is its formula. Magnesite. MgCO3 is its formula. These are the examples for carbonate minerals. Similarly, sulfide minerals. Iron pyrites. What is that, students? Iron pyrites. Its formula is Fe2. Zinc blend. Its formula is ZnS. Galena. Its formula is PbS. These are the few examples for sulfide ores. Similarly, halide ores. Cryolite. Na3AlF6. Similarly, gypsum. CaSO4 2H2O. So these are the few examples for the mineral. So these are the examples of the some minerals, and here the meaning of the mineral and ore. So now we have to know the another new terminologies in this chapter, that is the metallurgy chapter, that is the gangu. Okay student, the meaning of the gangu. So simple meaning, the unwanted material means nothing but unwanted impurities which are present in a ore, that is called as a gangu. Okay students, what is the meaning of gangu? Means nothing but it is a one type of the impurity which is present in a ore. So that will be called as a gangu. So in the ore, always the gangu will be eliminated in form of a molten state only. So this is the meaning about the gangu. Gangu means nothing but, what is the meaning of this? Impurity, unwanted impurity which is present in a ore. Then flux. Flux means nothing but it is the external substance which is added to the ore from the outside for lowering the melting point of a gangu, that is called as a flux. Okay students, here the new terminology, new word is the flux. What is the meaning of flux? Means it is the extra material, extra substance which can be added to the ore for lowering the melting point of the gangu. The type of substance is called as a flux. Okay student, flux means it is added to the ore. Added extra substance added to the ore for lowering the melting point of a gangu, that is called as a flux. Next, slag. Simple. When the gangu is combined with the flux, it is eliminated in form of the slag. Okay students, what is that? When gangu is react with the flux, it can be eliminated in form of the slag. In form of the slag. So that is the meaning about the slag.
Okay, student, clear? Gangum means nothing but it is a impurity. Phlegm means it does not present in a wort. It can be added to the outside. The use of the phlegm, it can be lower the melting point of a gangu. When this phlegm is react with the gangu, it can be eliminated as a slag. So this is the meaning about the gangu and phlegm and slag. These are the new terminology which is used in a metallurgy chapter. Now here we have to know the mineral ore and meaning of the gangu, phlegm and slag. So our main concept in this chapter is we can separate the metal from the ore. Okay students, here we can separate the extract the metal from the ore. How we can extract it? That can be discussed in this chapter. Simple. For example, the extraction of the metal. Our next topic is the extraction of metal from the ore. How we can extract the metal from the ore? For any metal can be extracted, nothing but separated from the ore, there are the five steps are involved. What is that? There are the mainly five steps are involved for a extraction of the metal. And that first step is the crushing or grinding. Okay student, first step is crushing or grinding of ore. Next, concentration of ore. Concentration of ore. Third one is conversion into the metal oxide. The ore is conversion into its metal oxide. Next step is reduction of metal oxide into a metal. Okay student, reduction of a metal oxide into a metal. Next step is the purification of the metal. Next step is the purification of the metal. So these are the mainly five steps are involved for the extraction of the metal from the ore. Okay students, how many steps? Five steps are involving. In which process? Extraction of metal from the ore. First step is crushing or grinding of the ore. That means ore is crushing or grinding. In second step, that crushed or grinding ore, we are increasing its concentration. That is the concentration of ore. So this concentrated of ore in third step is converted into a their metal oxide. So when in third step we are converted the metal oxide, in fourth step that metal oxide is reduced into the metal. That is the reduction of metal oxide into the metal. In fifth step, the extracted metal can be purified. That is the purification of the metal. These are the mainly five steps are involved for the extraction of metal from the ore. Let us discuss the one by one. First one is the crushing or grinding. Crushing or grinding. Step one is crushing or grinding. Simple. Crushing or grinding means when we are using the ball mills, here the ore is crushed or grinding by using the ball mills, it is converted into the powder form. Okay student, this is the ore. By using the ball mills or by using the grinding materials, it is converted into the powdered form, like a powdered form. So that is the step one, simple general logic. In step one, what is that? Crushing or grinding. So here we are using the ball mills, the ore is converted into the powdered form. That is the step one, crushing or grinding. So in previous we discussed the how we can extract the metal. So mainly there are the five steps are involving in that process. First step, crushing or grinding of the ore. Second step is concentration of the ore, means here we are increases the ore percentage. And the third step,
The ore is converted to their metal oxide. And in the fourth step, the metal oxide is reduced into the metal. And final step, we have purify the extracted metal. These are the five steps are involving for the extraction of the metal from the ore. So already we discussed the crushing or grinding. So now here we discuss the step 2, that is the concentration of ore. Simple meaning, students, concentration of ore means here we are remove the impurities. Okay, concentration of ore means ore percentage will be increases. How the ore percentage will be increases means we are remove the impurities. Impurities means nothing but here we are called as a terminology gangu. Okay, concentrated of ore means nothing but we are remove the impurities. So there are the different methods will be present for ore concentration will be increases. So in the concentrated of ore, there are the different methods will be present. On that, first method is the hand picking method. First one is the hand picking method. Simple, hand picking method means the unwanted impurities like a gangue particles will be removed with the hand. Impurities can be removed with the hand. Simply that is called as a hand picking method. Okay students, second method is the hydraulic washing method. What is that? Second method is the hydraulic washing method. So it is depend on the gravity separation method. It is also known as a gravity separation method. So in this hydraulic washing method, it is applicable only for oxide ores. Okay students, it is applicable for only for oxide ores. Hydraulic washing method, gravity separation method is applicable for only oxide ores like a hematite Fe2O3. Hematite formula Fe2O3 oxide ore. Like a pyrolusite, it's a formula MnO2. So hydraulic washing method is applicable for only oxide ores. Simple, in this method here the powdered ore is washed with flowing water. Here what can we do? Powdered ore is washing in presence of the flowing water. When washing in presence of flowing water, what will be occurs means the ore particles are heavier than impurities like a gangu. So they can settle down at the bottom. Okay students, here this is the hydraulic washing or gravity separation method. That is the second method in the concentrated of ore. So in the concentration of ore, another method is that is the froth flotation process. Froth flotation process, simple student. So in the froth flotation process, here we are take the one vessel. So on the vessel, we are using the powdered ore that can be obtained in the step 1. Okay student, powdered ore. So this froth flotation method is suitable for only sulfide ores. This froth flotation process is suitable for only sulfide ores. Okay students, so what we can do in a vessel? We are using the powdered sulfide ore. On that powdered sulfide ore, we are using the rotating paddle. So this is the act as a rotating paddle, and this powdered ore we are adding the some extra materials, that is like a froth agent. Example, sodium ethyl xanthate. Sodium ethyl xanthate. K
can be act as a froth agent. So that sodium ethyl xanthate froth agent is added to the powdered sulfide ore in this vessel. Then also we are adding the froth stabilizers. Why? Because here we are adding the froth agent means just it can be produce the froth. Simply that is called as a froth agent. Then you stabilize that froth. Then we are adding the froth stabilizers like amines, aniline or chrysal. Okay student, in this way vessel what we can add a froth stabilizer also, that is the like amines, aniline or chrysal. And also we are adding the collectors, example pine oil or olive oil will act as a collector, that is also added to this vessel. And also we are adding the for maintenance of the pH, lime or sodium carbonate is also added to the this vessel. Okay student, simple froth flotation here in this method is applicable for only sulfide ores. Here what we can do in froth flotation method, here we are using the one vessel, we are taking a vessel, on that vessel we are using the powdered sulfide ore. For that powdered sulfide ore we are added the some frothing agent like a sodium ethyl xanthate and some froth stabilizers like amines, aniline or chrysal, like a collectors pine oil or olive oil, for maintain the pH like a lime or sodium carbonate is added to the this vessel. And by using the this rotating paddle, the total mixture can be rotated. After the rotating, the mineral which is contained the froth can be settled here. The impurities can be settled. Impurities means nothing but gangu can be settled here. So this is the process will be occur in the froth flotation. Here this froth flotation, the main principle is metal particles are light than the impurities like a gangu. What is the main principle in the froth flotation process? The metal particles are lighter than the impurities gangu. So this is the main principle is involved in the froth flotation. So after rotating the rotating paddle, the mineral particles become wet by oil, while the gangu particles are wetted by the water. This is the final conclusion. What is that? Mineral particles become wetted by the oil, while gangu particles are wetted by the water. So this is the froth flotation process. It can be used for increasing the ore percentage, nothing but concentrated of ore. So in the concentration of ore, the third method is the froth flotation method. Simple froth flotation, what is the mean by the froth flotation means it is applicable for only sulfide ores. So the powdered sulfide ore is taken in a vessel, on that vessel we are adding the frothing agent like a sodium ethyl xanthate, and also we are adding the froth stabilizers like amines, aniline or chrysal, and also we are adding the collectors like palm oil or olive oil, and also we are adding the maintain the pH lime or sodium carbonate to the vessel. After adding, the rotating paddle is rotating. When the rotating paddle is rotated, the metal particles are lighter than the impurities. Then due to that, the minerals can be settled here and the impurities are settled in the bottom of the vessel. So the main conclusion for this froth flotation process is mineral particles become wetted by the oil, while the gangu particles are wetted by the water. So this is the simple method, that is the froth flotation method. Students, in previous classes in the metallurgy, general principles of metallurgy, we discussed the step 1 and step 2 also. So in step 2, the concentration of ore, that means ore concentration will be increases. So in previously we studied about the froth flotation process and hand picking method. Hand picking method, hydraulic washing method, and as well as froth flotation process. So now here we discuss the magnetic separation method. So another method in the increase in the concentration of ore, that is the magnetic separation. Simple. Magnetic separation means here the ore particles and impurity, nothing but gangu. Ore particles and gangu, one will be having the magnetic nature and another will do not having the magnetic nature. Due to that reason, here we are separated the ore particles from their impurities. Simply that is called as a magnetic separation. For example, easily understanding, here we draw the one diagram for magnetic separation. So this is the rotating rollers. So in this rotating rollers, here this roller will having the magnetic nature. So this is the magnetic roller. Okay students, this is the magnetic roller. Here we are using the two visuals. On that, one is the non-magnetic nature of visual and another one is the magnetic nature of the visual. So when the powdered ore is dipped in this way, this is the ore is entered in this way. When this magnetic roller is rotating, due to that rotating, non-magnetic nature of impurities will move towards to the this visual. And magnetic nature of ore particles are moving towards to the this vision. By using this magnetic nature, here we should separated the non-magnetic and magnetic ore and impurities. Simply that is called as a magnetic separation method. For example, this magnetic separation method is used wolframite ore. Wolframite ore, on that wolframite ore SnO2 is act as a impurity. Okay student, wolframite means FeWO4 plus MnWO4. This is the chemical formula for the wolframite. In this wolframite ore SnO2 is act as a impurity like a gangu. So by using the this magnetic separation method, we should separate the SnO2 impurity from wolframite ore. So this is the method of the magnetic separation. Okay students, next we move to the another method, that is the leaching method. What is that student? This is the leaching method. Another method is the leaching method. Here this leaching method is the chemical method. Up to magnetic separation, all are the physical process. For example, froth flotation, hydraulic washing, hand picking method and magnetic separation method. These all methods are only physical process, depend on the physical method. But here the leaching is example for the chemical method. So leaching means here we are using the chemical reagent. That means the ore is soluble in chemical reagent, then the impurity is insoluble on that chemical reagent. That means in leaching process, we are using the one chemical reagent. When we are using that chemical reagent, the ore particles are soluble on that chemical reagent and the impurities gangu are insoluble on that chemical reagent. By using this method, here we should separate the ore from their impurities. Okay students, so that is the leaching process. So in this leaching process, we are using the chemical reagent. For example, silver, RM and bauxite ores can be used in this leaching method. Okay students, silver, RM and bauxite can be used in this leaching process.
For example, if the silver having the impurity, okay student, for our understanding, silver and it will be having the impurity. Here we should separated that impurity from silver. Okay students, impurity can be separated from silver. So here we are using the in leaching process chemical reagent. So sodium cyanide is act as a chemical reagent. Okay student, sodium cyanide is act as a chemical reagent. So when silver having the impurity, if it is react with the sodium cyanide chemical reagent, when it is react with the sodium cyanide chemical reagent, then so silver containing the impurity, when it is react with the chemical reagent sodium cyanide, then the silver is soluble on that chemical reagent, then it is converted to the soluble form, that is the silver cyanide, and impurity is converted to the insoluble form. By using this method we should separated the impurity from the silver ore. So this is the leaching method. So this is the methods are present in the step 1, that is the concentration of ore, nothing but ore concentration will be increases. What type of the methods will be present means hydraulic washing method, hand picking method, froth flotation method, magnetic separation method and leaching method. These are the methods are used in the increasing the ore concentration. Next step, that is the third step, is metal is converted to the their metal oxide. Metal is converted to the their metal oxide. So here also there are the different type of the methods will be present for metal is converted to the their metal oxides. On the different methods, one is the roasting method. Roasting method means nothing but heating of the ore in presence of the excess air below its melting point, that is called as a roasting. What is that student? Heating of the ore in presence of excess air below its melting point is called as a roasting process. During this roasting, the ore is converted to the their metal oxide form. For example, here this roasting will be classified into the three types. One is oxidizing roasting, another one is sulfatizing roasting, another one is chloritizing roasting. Simple. Oxidizing roasting means during the roasting process, the ore is converted to the their oxide form. Sulfatizing roasting means during the roasting process, the ore is converted to the their sulfate form. Chloridizing roasting means during the roasting process, the ore is converted to the their chloride form. Let us see one by one with examples. For example, oxidizing roasting. So the ore is heated in presence of excess air, then the ore is converted to the their oxide form. Here also copper ore is converted to the their oxide during the roasting process, then it is called as a oxidizing roasting. For example, sulfatizing roasting. Sulfatizing roasting means nothing but during the roasting process, the ore is converted to the their sulfate form. Example, sulfide ore. During the roasting process, it is converted to the their sulfate, zinc sulfate, sulfate form. So simply that is called as a sulfatizing roasting. Next, chloridizing roasting. After roasting, the ore is converted to the their chloride form. Simply that is called as a chloridizing roasting. Example, silver sulfide. React with the sodium chloride in presence of the excess air, then it is silver ore is converted to the their chloride form. Simply that is called as a chloridizing roasting. So this is the meaning of the roasting. Next, another method is used when the metal is converted to the their metal oxide form, that is the calcination process.
simple. It is exactly reverse to the roasting. Okay, student. Roasting means heating of the ore in presence of excess air. Calcination means heating of the ore in absence of air, that is called as a calcination. Calcination means heating of the ore in absence of air, that is called as a calcination process. So, for example, it is applicable for the carbonate and hydrated ores. Calcination is applicable for carbonate and hydrated ores. For example, Fe2O3 XH2O, it is the hydrated ore. On heating, in absence of air, it is converted to the their oxide form. Similarly, zinc carbonate ore. On heating, in absence of air, it is converted to the their oxide form. So this is the calcination. Simple. Calcination means heating of the ore in absence of air, that is called as a calcination process. So this is the meaning about the roasting and calcination process. So here, in previous videos, we discussed the how the ore concentration will be increases and different type of the methods will be present, and similarly the methods which will be involved in the metal is converted to their metal oxide. So now here we discuss the another step, that is the reduction of the metal from its metal oxide. So reduction of the metal oxide into the metal, nothing but reduction of the metal oxide into the metal. This is the another step. So here, this reduction of metal oxide into the metal, this process is also called as a electronation process. It is also called as a electronation process. Why? Because the metal oxide reduced into the metal, it is called as electronation. Means here which process will be involved? Reduction. What is that? Reduction will be involved. Reduction means nothing but what is that? Addition of electrons. Adding of electrons. Addition of electrons. Electrons will be added. Simply that is called as a electronation, means electrons is added. So simply it is called as a electronation process. So reduction of the metal oxide into the metal, reduction of metal oxide into the metal, this is also known as electronation process. So here we have to know the pyrometallurgy method. Pyrometallurgy. Pyrometallurgy means nothing but it is a process of extraction of metal by heating the metal oxide with the suitable reducing agent. That is called as a pyrometallurgy. And this pyrometallurgy also known as thermal reduction process. Okay, students. Pyrometallurgy means nothing but the extraction of metal, extraction of the metal by heating the metal oxide, heating the metal oxide with suitable reagent, with suitable reducing reagent. That is called as a pyrometallurgy. Here in this process we are heating the metal oxide. So that is also known as thermal reduction process. Simple. Pyrometallurgy means we are reduce the metal oxide into the metal by using the suitable reducing reagents. So what are act as a reducing reagent means, example, carbon or carbon monoxide, coke or carbon monoxide will act as a reducing reagents. For example, extraction of iron metal. Example, extraction of copper metal. Example, extraction of tin and zinc metal. In these metal extraction, we are using the suitable reducing reagent is coke or carbon
monoxide.
Okay, students. For extraction of wolfram, titanium, chromium, manganese, we are using the sodium, aluminium, magnesium, and hydrogen gas as a reducing reagents. Okay, students. Sodium, aluminium, magnesium, hydrogen act as a reducing reagents for extraction of wolfram, titanium, chromium, and manganese metals. Example, extraction of wolfram metal, hydrogen gas is act as a reducing reagent. So, for example, extraction of titanium, magnesium is act as a reducing reagent. Example, extraction of chromium and manganese, the aluminium is act as a reducing reagent. Okay, students. And another reducing reagent is water gas. Water gas means nothing but CO plus H2. CO plus H2. This mixture is called as a water gas. So, this water gas is also act as a reducing reagent for the extraction of the nickel metal. For the extraction of the nickel metal, which will be act as a reducing reagent, CO plus H2 mixture, that is the water gas. So, these are using as a suitable reducing reagents. Next method is the smelting. Smelting means nothing but it is the chemical thermochemical process. So, smelting means nothing but it is a thermochemical process. So, the extraction of the metal from their metal oxide, when we are using the carbon or carbon monoxide as a reducing reagent, that process is called as a smelting process. Okay, students, simple. Extraction of the metal from their metal oxide when we using the carbon or carbon monoxide as a reducing reagent, then that process is called as a smelting process. In this smelting process, the metal is extracted in molten state. Metal is extracted in molten state. So, in this melting process, we are using the flux for removing the impurity like a gangue. So, in the smelting process, when we are extracted the metal in molten state, during this extraction process, we are using the flux for the removing the impurity like gangue. So, this is about the information of smelting. For example, here extraction of the iron. So, iron oxide means metal oxide. When here the reducing reagent is coke. So, the metal iron is extracted in the molten form. Iron is extracted in the molten form by the elimination of the carbon monoxide. Okay, students, metal oxide to extraction of the metal in the molten state. We are using the coke as a reducing reagent. So, this process is called as a smelting. During this process, we are using the slag, we are using the flux. For example, here the SiO2. For example, SiO2 is act as a flux and the gangue impurity is the calcium oxide. During the extraction of the iron from their ore, which is act as an impurity, calcium oxide is act as an impurity like a gangue. So, here in this melting process, we are adding the flux. So, SiO2 is act as a flux. When we are adding the flux to the gangue, so flux is react with the gangue and it can be eliminated as a slag. For example, SiO2 is added to the CaO gangue. When it is reactive with the flux with the CaO gangue, it can be eliminated calcium silicate in the form of the slag. So, this is the meaning about the smelting process. So,
here we discuss the reduction of the metal oxide into the metal. So on that reduction of the metal oxide into the metal, that process is also known as a electronation process. So here in this we are using the pyrometallurgy. Pyrometallurgy means nothing but extraction of the metal from their metal oxide. So we are heating the metal oxide in presence of the suitable reducing reagent. That is called as a pyrometallurgy. And the pyrometallurgy also called as a thermal reduction process. And coke and carbon monoxide is act as a reducing reagents. Water gas is also act as a reducing reagent. Aluminium, magnesium, hydrogen gas is also act as a reducing reagents. So smelting process. Smelting means the extraction of the metal from their metal oxide. When we are using the coke or carbon monoxide as a reducing reagent, that is called as a smelting process. So in this smelting process, the metal can be extracted in molten form, and in this smelting process the gangue impurity can be removed when we are adding the flux. So the gangue is react with the flux, it can be eliminated in form of the slag. This is the information about the smelting. Next here we discuss the auto reduction. Auto reduction means nothing but self reduction. So for example, here the silver sulfide react with the oxygen. So here the silver can be act as a reduction reagent. So it can be extracted in form of the silver. So this is the self reduction, auto reduction process. It is also used in the another example. For example, Ce2S cuprous sulfide react with the cuprous oxide. Here this step is involved for extraction of the copper metal. So cuprous sulfide react with the cuprous oxide, which will be act as a reducing reagent for the extraction of the copper oxide. Okay student, so copper extraction, so sulfide form and oxide form will be act as a reducing reagent. So it is called as a auto reduction, self reduction. So same metal will act as a reducing reagent, that is called as a auto reduction or self reduction. This auto reduction or self reduction is used in the extraction of the copper from their ore. Next method is the hydrometallurgy. Hydrometallurgy means nothing but the process of extraction of metal by dissolving the ore in suitable chemical reagent. What is that? Hydrometallurgy means the process of extraction of the metal by the dissolving the ore in suitable chemical reagent and precipitate of metal by more electropositive metal is called as a hydrometallurgy. Hydrometallurgy means nothing but, students, what is the meaning of hydrometallurgy? Hydrometallurgy means when the extraction of the metal, the ore is dissolved in suitable chemical reagent. When it is dissolved in suitable chemical reagent, the precipitate will be formed. So that precipitate is react with the more electropositive metal. That process is called as a hydrometallurgy. It can be easily understood by using the simple example. For example, silver glands. Here extraction of this silver, the ore is the silver glands, that is the Ag2S. It is react with the suitable chemical reagent, that is the sodium cyanide. Okay student, ore is react with the suitable chemical reagent, example sodium cyanide. When it will be formed the precipitate, this is the precipitate, that is the sodium argentocyanide, this is the precipitate. So that precipitate is react with the more electropositive, this is the more electropositive, more electropositive metal compare with which metal?
our extracted metal silver. Okay, student, this precipitate react with the more electro positive metal. Compare with our extracted metal, that is the silver. Okay, so precipitate react with the more electro positive metal, then the metal will be extracted, means the silver will be extracted. This process is called as a hydrometallurgy process. Okay student, this is the meaning about the hydrometallurgy. Hydrometallurgy means nothing but the ore is dissolving by the suitable chemical reagent. When it is dissolved in suitable chemical reagent, the precipitate will be formed. That precipitate again react with the metal. That metal will having the more electro positive nature. When it is react with that electro positive nature metal, immediately the metal will be separated from that precipitate. This process will be called as a hydrometallurgy process. So this is the meaning about the smelting, auto reduction and hydrometallurgy process. So in previous class we discussed the how the metal will be extracted from their metal oxide. So how the metal is extracted from their metal oxide. So we discussed the there are the number of methods will be present. For example, roasting method, calcination method and smelting process and reduction process and hydrometallurgy process. So by using that process, we should separate the metal from their metal oxide. So now here we learn about the when the metal will be separated from their ore. Little amount of the very less amount of the impurities also present on that extracted metal. That means in extracted metal very small amount of the impurity will be present. Here we are remove that impurity also. So that is the last step, our metallurgy, extraction of the metal. So that step is the purification or refining of the extracted metal. It is the purification or refining of the extracted metal. So here also different methods, different process will be present for the purification of metals. For the purification of the metals, there are the different type of the process will be present. So let's learn one by one. First one is the distillation process. For the purification, first method is the distillation. Here this distillation is applicable for the metals which will be having the low boiling point metals. Okay students, metals with low boiling point, metals with low boiling point, then that metals can be purified by using the distillation process. So impure metal is evaporated, then get the pure metal. In this distillation process, what will be occur? Impure metal is evaporated, then we get the pure metal. So this is the principle is involved in the distillation process. So which type of the metals is purified in the distillation process? Means zinc, cadmium and mercury. Zinc, cadmium and mercury metals are distilled, purified in the distillation process. So next method for the purification, that is the liquation process. What is that students? That is the liquation. Here this liquation is applicable for low melting point containing metals. For the low melting point, what is that? Low melting point. The metals which will having the low melting point, that metals can be purified by using the liquation method.
Example, stannous and lead. Stannous and lead is purified in the liquation process.
Next process is the for the purification, that is the poling method. What is that, students? Poling method. So in this poling method, the metal oxide as a impurity, then we are using the poling method. What is that? Metal oxide as a impurity. For example, copper. This is the metal. So in this copper, its oxide means copper oxide is act as a impurity. Okay, students. Here we are purify the copper metal. Which will be impurity on that copper metal? Its oxide means example copper oxide as a impurity. Then this type of metal is purified by using the poling method. Okay, students. Simple. Poling method means metal oxide as a impurity. Then we are using the poling process. So in this poling process, what will be occur means, first the metal is covered by the carbon powder. Metal is covered by the carbon powder like that, and then stirred with the green wood poles. Then this total mixture is stirred with the green wood poles. When we are stirred with the green wood poles, the metal oxide impurity can be removing. Then we are get the pure metal. So this is the process is possible in the poling process. So for example, copper metal is purified by using the this poling process. Copper metal is purified by using the that poling process. Another process for the purification, that is the cupellation process. Okay, students, another method, another process is the cupellation. So in this cupellation, easily oxidizable impurity is present. Easily oxidizable impurity means impurity is easily converted to the their oxide form. Simply, that is the easily oxidizable impurity is present. Then we are using the cupellation process. Cupellation process, which type of the metals is purified on that cupellation process? The metal which is having the easily oxidizable impurity. Okay, students, metal which having the easily oxidizable impurity, then we are using the cupellation. For example, in this cupellation method, which metal can be purified means silver. Example, silver. So that is the meaning about the cupellation. Next process is the well-known process, that is the electrolytic refining. Electrolytic refining. So in this electrolytic refining, we are purifying the metal. Simple, we are using the electrolysis process. So already we have to know, we have to learn the electrolysis process in the electrochemistry chapter. What is the meaning of the electrolysis means? One electrolytic cell means one vessel will be present that can be act as electrolytic cell. And on that electrolytic cell, we are using the electrolytic solution. And two electrodes, one will be act as anode, another will be act as a cathode. And they are connected to the positive end of the battery and similarly negative end of the battery. When we apply the current to the that electrodes, then the electrolysis process will be occurs. So by using the this process, by using the this method, we can purify the metal. Simply, that is called as a electrolytic refining. For example, in electrolytic refining, already we have to know this is the electrolytic cell. Okay, student. Example, this is the vessel. It will be act as electrolytic cell. And in this electrolytic cell, we are using the electrolytic solution. Electrolytic solution. And here we are using the two electrodes. One electrode will be act as a cathode.
that is connected to the negative end of the battery.
And here important one is the cathode, always the pure metal act as a cathode. Okay student, in electrolytic refining the pure metal, always the pure metal will act as a cathode. Then impure metal will be act as a anode. This is the principle for the electrolytic refining of the metals. What is that? Always the pure metal is taken as a cathode and the impure metal is taken as a anode. When we apply the current, then the metal will be purified. So this is the meaning of the electrolytic refining. So in this electrolytic refining, we should purify the metal. The main principle in the electrolytic refining is anode is the impure metal, cathode is the pure metal. So this is the meaning about the electrolytic refining. So another method for purification of the metal, that is the zone refining method. So zone refining method. So in this zone refining method, the main principle is the impurities are more soluble in the melt than that of the solid metal. What is that principle? The impurities are more soluble in the melted state than that of the solid state of the metal. So this is the main principle is involving the zone refining process. So in the zone refining process, what is the main principle for the purification of metal? The impure metal, nothing but the impurities are more soluble in the melt than in the solid state of the metal. This is the main principle is involving in the zone refining method. So this zone refining is easily explained by using the one diagram. So for example, in this is the one visual. Here these are the rotating induction coil heaters. These are the induction coil heaters. For example, this is the our metal rod. This is the our metal rod, and this zone is the molten zone. Okay student, this zone is the molten zone. When these induction coil heaters are the rotating towards to forward direction, okay, these coils are rotating towards to the forward direction, then the impurities are more soluble compared with the solid metal. So this is the main principle is occurs in the zone refining method. So next, another method for refining of the metal, that is the vapor phase refining. So another one is the vapor phase refining. Simple, vapor phase refining means in this method certain metals are converted into their volatile components. Okay students, what is that? In this method, certain metals are converted into their volatile compounds, whereas the impurities are not affected. So this is the process is involving in the vapor phase refining. So in the vapor phase refining, the metals are converted to their volatile compounds. On that volatile compounds, the impurities are not much affected. So this is the principle is involving in the vapor phase refining. So in this vapor phase refining, there are the two processes will be present. One is the Mohn's process, another one is the Van Arkel method. One is the Mohn's process, another one is the Van Arkel method. So Mohn's process is especially for nickel, purification of the nickel metal, and Van Arkel method especially for purification of the zirconium metal. So for example, in Mohn's process, so the impure nickel is reacted with the carbon monoxide. Impure nickel react with the carbon monoxide and heated nearly 60 to 80 degrees Celsius, then that is converted to the their volatile, that means their vapor phase, that is the tetracarbonyl nickel. When these intermediate compound again heating at 180 to 200 degrees Celsius, then we are get the pure nickel. So this is the process is involving in the Mohn's process. Simple. So impure nickel react with the carbon monoxide, on heating we will get the intermediate compound, again that on heating at high temperatures finally we get the pure nickel metal. So this is the Mohn's process. So in Van Arkel method, impure zirconium react with the iodine, heating at 870 Kelvin temperature, then we get the intermediate compound zirconium iodide. Again this heating more temperatures, again that can be heating more temperature nearly 2075 Kelvin temperature, then we get the pure zirconium, pure zirconium. So this is the Van Arkel method for the purification of the zirconium metal. So in Van Arkel method, zirconium can be purified. In Mohn's process, nickel can be purified. These are the two methods are present in the vapor phase refining. Means first impure metals are converted to the their volatile, means vapor phase. Then we get the pure metals in the Mohn's process as well as in Van Arkel method. Next purification method, that is the chromatographic method. Next one is the chromatographic method. Simple, in this chromatographic method, for example, we are using the column chromatography. On that column chromatography, there are the two different phases will be present. On that one will be act as a stationary phase, another will be act as a mobile phase. One is called as a stationary phase and another will call as a mobile phase. So in the stationary phase, the solid or liquid will act as a stationary phase and impure metal is act as a mobile phase in the chromatographic technique. Okay students, in chromatographic method, stationary phase and mobile phase, two phases will be present. Solid or liquid will be act as a stationary phase and impure metal will act as a mobile phase. And what is the main principle is involving in the chromatographic method? Means the different components are adsorbed at different levels on the column. This is the main principle is involving in the chromatographic method. What is that? Different components are adsorbed. Different components are adsorbed at different levels on the column. This is the main principle is involved in the chromatographic method. For example, so this is the rough diagram for the column chromatography. So in this column chromatography, stationary phase, mobile phase, there are the two phases will be present and impure metal will be act as a mobile phase and solid or liquid material will be act as a stationary phase. So different components are adsorbed at different levels on the column. So this is the main principle is involving in the this chromatography technique or chromatographic method. So these are the purification of the metals. What is that? These methods are the purification of the metal. For example, chromatographic method and vapor phase refining, similarly zone refining, electrolytic refining, poling process, cupellation process, distillation process and liquation process. So these all are the, what is that? Purification of the metal. Purification of the metal. We are using the different methods for different metals. So in this, in previous classes we discussed the what are the steps are involved in the extraction of the metals. First step is the crushing or grinding of the ore. Second step is the increase in the concentration of ore, that is the concentration of ore. Third step is the extraction of the metal. So on that extraction of the metal, first metal is converted to the their metal oxide form, and again metal is separated from that metal oxide, that is the reduced of the metal from the metal oxide, and finally we are purify the extracted metal. So these are the main steps are involving the extraction of the metals from their ore. So now here we study about the few examples. For example, extraction of the copper from copper pyrites. What is the students? Extraction of the copper from copper pyrites. Copper pyrites ore. Copper pyrites ore formula is the CuFeS2. CuFeS2. This is the copper pyrites. So extraction of the copper from the copper pyrites. First step is the crushing or grinding. So we are using the ball mills. We are crushed or grinding of the copper pyrites ore. Then it is converted to the powdered form. Then second, the next one is the increasing the ore percentage, that is the concentration of the ore. For example, copper pyrites is the example for sulfide ore. So concentration of ore percentage will be increases, ore concentration will be increases. Which process is suitable means froth flotation. Froth flotation. Froth flotation process is used for increasing in the concentration of the ore. Okay student, which process will be using? Froth flotation process. So already we have to know the froth flotation. So on that froth flotation process, we are using the sodium ethyl xanthate as a frothing agent, and collectors and stabilizers, we are adding the that material. So that is the main principle is involving in the froth flotation. So your ore concentration will be increases. For increasing the ore concentration, we are using the which type of method? Froth flotation method. Why? Because means copper pyrites ore is the sulfide ore. So already we have to learn for sulfide ores, which is the suitable froth flotation process is suitable for increasing in the ore concentration. This is the next step. Then concentrated ore, from that concentrated ore, we are converted the ore into their metal oxide. So when, if it is converted to the metal oxide, we are using the which type of the process? Roasting process. So here also we are using the roasting process. In this roasting process, partially roasted on reverberatory furnace, the concentrated ore in the roasting is partially roasted on the reverberatory furnace. During this process, sulfur, phosphorus, arsenic, stibine like impurities removed as their volatile oxides. Okay students, in the roasting process, partially roasted on the reverberatory furnace, the concentrated ore is partially roasted in reverberatory furnace. So during that partially roasted in the reverberatory furnace, sulfur, phosphorus, arsenic, stibine like impurities can be removed, their volatile oxide. So what are the reactions that takes place in the roasting process of copper pyrites ore means? So the copper pyrites heating with oxygen, it is converted to the their cuprous sulfide, iron sulfide, and it is eliminated sulfur dioxide gas. And the iron sulfide again involved in the roasting, it is converted to the their iron oxide, metal oxide, by removing the sulfur dioxide gas.
and this cuprous sulfide in the roasting process it is converted to the their oxide form. So what are the reactions are involved in the roasting? First, copper pyrite is involved in the roasting. It is converted to their cuprous sulfide and iron sulfide by removing the sulfur dioxide gas. So this iron sulfide involved in the roasting, it is converted to the iron oxide by removing the sulfur dioxide gas. And this cuprous sulfide involved in the roasting, and it is converted to the their oxide, that is the cuprous oxide, by eliminating the sulfur dioxide gas. So these are the reactions are involving in the roasting of the copper pyrites. So copper pyrites, finally it is converted to iron oxide and cuprous oxide. Then this roasted material, that means roasted on the roasted of the copper pyrite is poured, finally what will be there? Iron oxide and cuprous oxide. So these materials is involving in the smelting process. So in the smelting, the roasted ore reacted with coke and sand. What is that, students? In the smelting, the roasted ore means this one. These are the roasted ore. So these roasted ore reacted with coke and sand. Here the sand will act as a flux. Sand will be act as a flux. Roasted ore react with the coke and sand and heated in blast furnace. Heated in the blast furnace. What are the reactions? So iron sulfide react with the oxygen, then this iron sulfide is converted to the iron oxide by elimination of the sulfur dioxide gas. And this iron oxide react with the sand, that is the silica. This is the flux. So iron oxide is react with the iron oxide is react with the flux. Here which is act as a flux? Sand, SiO2 will be act as a flux. And when iron oxide is react with the silica flux, and it can be eliminated as iron silicate. It is the slag. Iron silicate, it will be slag. That means what we will be done here, iron oxide can be eliminated in form of the iron silicate slag when it is react with the silica sand flux. So during this process, if any oxide of copper is formed, what is that, students? During this melting process, if any oxide of copper is formed, it combined with iron sulfide and changes back into sulfide. So any copper oxide is formed, it again combined with iron sulfide and it change back into the sulfide form. That means cuprous sulfide react with the oxygen, cuprous oxide and sulfur dioxide. And that cuprous oxide, any oxide of copper is combined with the iron sulfide, combined with the iron sulfide and change back into their sulfide form. So cuprous oxide react with the iron sulfide and again it is converted to the cuprous sulfide and iron oxide. These are the reactions are possible in the smelting process. So here cuprous sulfide and iron oxide will be formed. So here the formation, this iron oxide, again iron oxide is removed as iron silicate slag. Here the formation iron oxide can be removed from the mixture as a iron silicate, that is the slag. In lower layer of the blast furnace, in lower layer, the molten mass of the cuprous sulfide, iron sulfide will be formed. What is that, students? In lower layer, the molten mass of the cuprous sulfide and iron sulfide mixture will be formed.
This cuprous sulfide and iron sulfide mixture is called as a matte. What is that meaning of the matte? It is the mixture of the cuprous sulfide and iron sulfide. So the mixture of the cuprous sulfide and iron sulfide will be called as a matte. So this matte mixture is undergoes the Bessemerization. On that Bessemerization process, if any iron sulfide present in matte, okay student, matte means it is a mixture of the cuprous sulfide and iron sulfide. During the Bessemerization, if any iron sulfide is present in the matte, it is oxidized to iron oxide. When it is oxidized to iron oxide and it is removed as slag. Okay student, clear? In the matte, matte means it is the mixture of the cuprous sulfide and iron sulfide. In the Bessemerization process, this iron sulfide from the matte is oxidized to iron oxide, and that iron oxide is removed as a slag, that is the iron silicate. So cuprous sulfide is partially oxidized to the cuprous oxide. Cuprous sulfide is partially oxidized to the cuprous oxide. Finally, that cuprous oxide react with the cuprous sulfide. This cuprous oxide react with the cuprous sulfide and it is converted to the copper. So this is the auto reduction or self reduction. So cuprous oxide is reduced to the copper when it is react with cuprous sulfide. This reduction, this step will be called as a auto reduction or self reduction. Finally, here extracted, separated this copper is 98% of the pure. This copper is 98% of the pure copper. So that is 98% of the pure copper is called as a blister copper. What is that students? Blister copper. Blister copper means nothing but if the 98% of copper will be formed by the escaping of the sulfur dioxide gas. That is called as a blister copper. Blister copper means the 98% of the copper can be obtained by the escaping of the sulfur dioxide gas. That copper is called as a blister copper. Here this blister copper, extracted copper is 98% of the pure. Then we are get the 100% of the copper. So this extracted copper is purified. Already we have to learn the purification method. There are the number of methods will be present. For this copper, which is the suitable means electrolytic refining. So electrolytic method is used for purification of that copper. So already we have to learn the electrolytic refining or electrolytic method for purification of the copper is cathode will act as a pure metal and anode will act as a impure metal, and we are using the suitable electrolytic solution. By using that electrolytic refining, here we can purify this, obtaining 98% of the copper. Finally, we are get the 100% of the copper. So this is the steps are involved in the extraction of the copper from the copper pyrites. These are the process is involving in the extraction of the copper from copper pyrites. Okay. So in previous class we discussed about how the extraction of the copper from copper pyrites and what are the steps and what are the reactions are involved, chemical reactions are involved on that extraction of the copper from the copper pyrites. Now here we going to explain the how the extraction of the zinc from the zinc blend. So here the zinc can be extracted from the zinc blend ore. So step 1, what is the step 1? So in step one, first by using the ball mills, they are crushed or grinding the ore. Then the ore is converted to the powdered form. So here also by using the ball mills, the zinc blend ore on grinding, it is converted to the powdered form. Then in step two, we are increasing the concentration of the ore. So here also powdered zinc blend ore, concentration of ore is increases. First with gravity method, okay student, first with gravity method, then we are using the froth flotation method. So already we have to know the froth flotation method. So by using the gravity method and by using the froth flotation method, we are increasing the ore percentage, nothing but ore concentration. Then in next step, that froth flotation, that means ore concentration, increasing the ore concentration. So ore percentage will be increases, then that ore is undergoing the roasting process. So already we have to know, roasting means heating of the ore in presence of the excess air, that is called as a roasting process. So during the roasting, the chemical reaction on heating in presence of air, what is the chemical reactions is possible means the zinc sulfide, zinc blend ore on heating in presence of the excess air, this is converted to the zinc oxide by elimination of the sulfur dioxide gas. Then again zinc sulfide on heating with oxygen, then it is converted to the zinc sulfate. So that zinc sulfate on heating nearly 1200 Kelvin temperature, it is converted to zinc oxide by eliminating of the sulfur dioxide gas and oxygen gas. So these are the reactions is possible in the roasting process. So finally we get the zinc oxide. Zinc blend ore is involving in the roasting. It is finally converted to the zinc oxide, metal oxide form. Then what we here we do, the reduction of the this metal oxide means zinc oxide, that is the step. So reduction of the zinc oxide. So here the coke and carbon monoxide is used as a reducing agent. For example, here the reaction is zinc oxide react with coke at 1100 to 1200 degree Celsius, then it is converted to zinc by eliminating the carbon monoxide. Here this carbon monoxide, again if any remaining zinc oxide is present, so that carbon monoxide is react with that remaining zinc oxide, finally it is converted to the zinc by eliminating the carbon dioxide gas. So here the extracted this zinc is called as a smelter zinc. Okay student, this zinc is called as a, what is that, smelter zinc. This is called as a smelter zinc. Smelter zinc means here this zinc contains the lead and cadmium as a impurities. Lead and cadmium as a impurities, then that is called as a smelter zinc. So this smelter zinc poured in a steam water, finally we are get the zinc. This smelter zinc is poured in a steam water, finally we get the zinc. So this is the extraction of the zinc. Then after that, what will we do here? The refining. Next step is the refining, nothing but purification or refining of the this extracted zinc. So already we have to know, for refining we are using the which process, that is the electrolytic refining. Electrolytic refining means anode, cathode and electrolytic, suitable electrolytic solution will be present. So the main conclusion, main concept in electrolytic refining is the pure form is act as a cathode. So if the pure zinc is taken as a cathode and the impure zinc is taken as a anode, by the electrolysis process finally we are get the purest form of the zinc, that is the refining of the zinc. So these are the steps are involved in the extraction of the zinc from the zinc blood. These are the reactions. So next one is the extraction of the silver metal from the silver glass ore. Next is the extraction of the silver from the silver glands, means Ag2S. So here this process is called as a cyanamide process, and this process is also called as a MacArthur-Forrest process. What is the MacArthur-Forrest process? So what are the steps and what is the reactions are involved in the extraction of the silver from silver glass? Let us see. So first step, same process, that is the crushing or grinding. So by using the ball mills, here also silver glands is involving in the crushing or grinding. Finally we get the powdered form of the silver glass ore. Then step 2, what will here we do? We are increasing in the ore concentration, nothing but ore percentage will be increases, that is the concentration of ore. So concentration of ore, by using the froth flotation method, we are increasing the ore concentration. Then that concentrated ore is involving in the leaching process. Here which process, which method will be using? Leaching method. So in the leaching method, the suitable reagent, what is that students? Suitable chemical reagent will be using in the leaching process. Earlier we discussed the leaching method. So here the suitable chemical reagent is sodium cyanide. Sodium cyanide is suitable chemical reagent. When the silver glass powdered ore is reacted with the suitable chemical reagent sodium cyanide, then it is converted to the precipitate form, that is the sodium argentocyanide. This is the precipitate form. Sodium argentocyanide is precipitate form. So by using the suitable chemical reagent, example sodium cyanide, the powdered silver glass ore is converted to the sodium argentocyanide precipitate. And here the byproduct is the sodium sulfide Na2S. So that sodium sulfide is reacted with the moisture of oxygen. It is converted to the sodium hydroxide and sodium thiosulfate Na2S2O3. So that Na2S2O3 again react with the sodium hydroxide in presence of air. Finally, it can be eliminated as sodium sulfate. That means, students, here the sodium sulfide finally is eliminated in which form? As a sodium sulfate, Na2SO4. So here only the precipitate, sodium argentocyanide precipitate will be present. So in the hydrometallurgy process, so already we have to learn the hydrometallurgy. Hydrometallurgy means here the formation precipitate in leaching process, formation precipitate is react with the more electropositive element. So in the hydrometallurgy, that precipitate sodium argentocyanide is react with the more electropositive element, that is the zinc. Finally, it is converted to the sodium zincate form, and finally we are extracted the our metal, that is the silver. Okay students, so this precipitate in the hydrometallurgy, this precipitate is react with the zinc. Finally, in place of the silver, the zinc will be deposited. Finally, the silver can be extracted from that precipitate. So this is the extraction of the silver from silver glass. So finally, we are extracted the silver. Then next step is the purification, that is the refining of the extracted metal. For the refining or purification, here we are using the electrolytic method. So in the electrolytic method, already we have to know suitable electrolytic solution will be present, and anode and cathode will be present. Always the cathode is the pure metal is act as a cathode, and the impure metal is act as a anode. On electrolysis, during the electrolysis, finally we are get the purest form of the silver metal. So this is the reactions and the various steps are involved in the extraction of the silver from the silver glands.
Next, here we discuss the extraction of the iron from hematite ore. Here, hematite. Iron can be extracted from
hematite ore. So here this iron can be extracted from the hematite ore. Here the total process is done in the reverberatory furnace or blast furnace. For example, when we are using the blast furnace for the extraction of the iron from the hematite ore, the various steps, various reactions will be occurs at the different temperature in the blast furnace. So in the blast furnace, the different temperature ranges will be present. So during the extraction of the iron from the hematite ore, what are the reactions? What is the reactions that takes place in the blast furnace at different temperature ranges? So here we discuss the that reaction. For example, in the blast furnace at 400 to 700 degree Celsius, the hematite ore Fe2O3 react with the carbon monoxide. Then this Fe2O3 is converted to the their oxide FeO by the elimination of the carbon dioxide gas. And at that same temperature range, this iron oxide react with the carbon monoxide and it is converted to the iron by the elimination of the carbon dioxide gas. So these are the two reactions are possible in the blast furnace at 400 to 700 degree Celsius temperature range. For example, at 800 to 1000 degree Celsius temperature range, the carbon dioxide is reacted with the coke and it is converted to the carbon monoxide, and the calcium carbonate is dissociated as calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So this calcium oxide is reacted with the silica and it is eliminated in form of the calcium silicate as a slag. So these are the reactions are possible in the blast furnace at 800 to 1000 degree Celsius temperature. And at 1100 to 1300 degree Celsius temperature, the remaining coke is react with the oxygen and converted to the carbon dioxide. If any iron oxide at 400 to 700 degree Celsius, iron oxide is converted to the iron. If any remaining iron oxide will be present, that iron oxide at 1100 to 1300 degree Celsius temperature is react with the coke and finally it is converted to the iron. So these are the reactions are possible at 1100 to 1300 degree Celsius temperature in blast furnace. So this is the different type of the reaction is occurs in the different type of the temperature ranges in the blast furnace during the extraction of the iron from hematite ore. So finally we are get the iron. Here this extracted obtained iron is called as a pig iron. Okay student, this iron will called as a pig iron. Pig iron means it having the 4% of the carbon content. So 4% of the carbon content containing iron is called as a pig iron. It is the very impure form of the iron. It is the very impure form of the iron. So on melting of this pig iron, we get the cast iron. So this cast iron will having the 3% of the carbon content. So on melting of the pig iron, finally we get the cast iron. This cast iron will having the 3%, that means less percentage of carbon containing iron form is the cast iron. It will have the 3%. So on distillation, finally we get the wrought iron. So this wrought iron will having the only 0.5% of the carbon content. So this is the purest form of the iron, that is the wrought iron, because it will having the very less amount of the carbon, nearly that is 0.5%. So this is the extraction of the iron. So first we get the extracted the pig iron. So that pig iron is converted to the cast iron, and the cast iron is converted to the wrought iron. So this is the meaning about the pig iron, wrought iron and cast iron. Which is the purest form of the iron? Means wrought iron. And which is the impure form of the iron? Means pig iron. So these are the steps and reactions is involved in the extraction of the iron from hematite ore.